Hey guys, it's Lasty Girl. So this is something totally different that I usually do on here, so I hope you guys will enjoy this. I always wanted to do something like this and to share my game experience and opinion with you guys and discuss certain topics in video games. For now, I'm going to review the game Soul Calibur 6. I would like to thank Bandai Namco for the early copy so I can make a review earlier. I never really played the Soul Calibur franchise. You guys know that I played Soul Calibur 6 Network Test, and I really got into it because of you guys. Some of you told me, "Hey Lossy, can you try it?" And I said, "Yeah, sure, why not?" And I really enjoyed it and played it a few times off stream and on stream too. Oh, and there is a block button. You guys know how much I love a block button in a fighting game. So guys, I'm very happy that it got recommended to me by you guys, so thanks again. I really appreciate it. First of all, I'm going to talk about the different topics in Soul Calibur 6. I'm going to start off with the practice mode to learn basics. As a fighting game player, I will directly go to the practice mode. So whenever you go to battle and then training, I expected another screen with different kind of trainings or tutorial, but there isn't. So in the training, you pick up a fighter and you can set some things up how you wish to fight against the dummy. I think this could be confusing for beginners like me who never played the game before. So if you go to training settings during practicing, it gives you different options. You can see the move list of the character you picked. So the first time I was looking at the move list, I was like, huh? What does this mean? But yeah, it's a good thing at the left side of the options screen, it shows what is. And now it's kind of obvious that H means high, M means middle, and L means low. Like the main attacks, reversal edge attack, horizontal and vertical attacks, and many more. I expected under combat lessons some things about a tutorial that's helping you out during the training. But no, you can select a certain character and there's a lot of information about that character. I don't really like to read a lot, I just want to play with the help of the AI or a tutorial that I have to go through. I can't remember all the information all at once, so that's gonna take a while if I want to understand everything. You can also set up the dummy character like you usually see in fighting games, which is awesome. So I thought there wasn't a tutorial the whole time, but after I played the mode Libera of Souls, I saw that there is a mission called Training. It really helps you to understand the basics of the fighting gameplay and also the advanced gameplay too. Attacking and defense trainings are there. Here you can see some examples of the training. Really good and it helped me to understand it better. Sometimes it was hard to understand some aspects, but I think it's just me. I'm still learning, guys. I would have loved to see this at the training section in the game, but at least it's in it, so yeah, I'm glad. So guys, if you want to get better at this game, you should definitely try this. Player ranked competitive. So ranked is a competitive online play in Soul Calibur 6. You fight for points based on your battle results in this battle mode and work your way up the rankings. I really hope that you play with players around your rank score. You can find a match easier whenever you put your preferred connection status lower and region on all regions. There's a chance you will find a laggy match though. I did it and I found a match quickly. It was the same during the network test. So I played my first match versus a Geralt that stayed on the ground, so I guess he was AFK. So I tried to do the casual games, but you have to create a room to wait for a match. I couldn't find anyone there. So I can't really say anything about this. I guess it will be easier to find people when the game is released. The game has an unique way of storytelling that I never seen before. Pictures of the characters who are having conversation. Their expressions change sometimes in the pictures whenever they are angry, shocked, excited, and so on. There were a lot of pictures that describe the events. It makes you fantasize how it would be. Then during an encounter versus an enemy, you got to fight them for a few rounds and then the story continues. Medium was kinda easy for me. I think it's because I got some experience in other fighting games. I try to press crazy combinations like back 2-2-2, forward 1-1-1, those kind of combos. Yeah, it helped me out. The goal in the whole story is to find out where the Soul Edge is. I finished the story in around 3 hours. I thought there would be more cinematics. I only saw 3 short ones. I think the chosen style of storytelling isn't that immersive. Sometimes I want to see some action starting. And when the story goes over to a battle, the loading screen takes a bit long. I really like the interaction between Killik and Shenhua. They're very nice. I can say Shenhua is definitely one of my favorite characters in the game, and I will probably be maining her. I really like her sword, she kinda reminds me of Li Mei in Mortal Kombat Deception. The villains in this game weren't that terrifying, I kinda expected more from them. Serentis though, he looks very creepy. The side story missions. So next to the main story, there are side story missions for every character. Every character has its own story. It's kind of the same storytelling as the main story. And I really have to mention this ring out is so fun when it works. I really like the voice acting in this game. The writing sometimes is too cheesy, but that belongs in fighting games. Like, I'm stronger than you, and those kind of interactions. Well, if you say so, like they are challenging each other. The characters I love because of the story are Taki, she's an amazing representation of a female ninja. Shenhua, she's such an innocent and nice soldier. Killik, he was the main character and he was super cool. And also Maxi. Sophie Tia was also nice, she's very humble and sweet. And I have to say that I played the Tira side story and it was super dark. I was kinda in shock because I didn't expect something that dark in this game. I still like her though, but her background is super freaky. I think they have done a great job at making the characters in this game very likable. Libra of Soul mode. So this mode has an RPG aspect in it. You can choose for being a hero or being the villain. First, you start off with customizing your own character. I tried to make myself, of course, with a bit of Melina in it. So the most curly hair and Melina's size, that's like the perfect combination for me. Wow, I just found out the Melina style weapon is Afodo, the weird fight style character. Look how she moves, it's so weird. What do you guys think of my design? I'm very proud of it. During the missions, you can ask some questions, but it's all reading. There's not really a voice acting thing going on in this mode. I don't like reading, and in these missions, you have to read everything. Asking questions is interesting, but sometimes there's way too much focus on it. I think it depends what kind of gamer you are. I'm someone that likes action, and story is also important, but it depends how it's brought up in the story. I think only reading text doesn't make it immersive. I like the RPG aspect in this though, different than the story mode. So I had so much fun in this section, I can't even describe it. I always spend so much time in games to customize my own character, so this is like the perfect place for me. At some point you can see others' creations, so that's gonna be super awesome. So there are two different main customization in the game. Original character customization and Soul Calibur 6 character customization. Start with selecting a race. Of course I went for the Revenant. It reminded me of Mortal Kombat. Zerohox, I think you would love Lizardman, winky face. It's really cool to see there are many different kind of options to choose out of. Let's check the Revenant. It's amazing to see how much effort is done in the weapon style. Every character has its own different kind of weapons, and then you can even choose different styles of that weapon. You can change the body build of your character. I tried to change my skeleton body build. But yeah, that's not gonna work. I have like the wrong example. Even change colors of your equipped weapon and clothing, which is super cool. It's super cool because I like to match everything, or sometimes I want to try the craziest combination with all the rainbow colors. Ah, I miss this so much in games. Last time that I made my own character in a fighting game, it was in Mortal Kombat, Armageddon, Create Your Fighter. So yeah, that's like a long time ago. So the next section is the Battle Commons part, which is so fun. You can choose lines at certain points during the fight that your character will be using the lines. You can think of the most iconic, badass, or the craziest combinations. For example, when your character is upon losing, you just say, "Thank you." You can also choose to show off, casual, hardcore, or standard, and it will be already done for you. But yeah, I'm someone that likes to goof around, so I choose the super wrong combinations to make the fight funnier. So almost at the end, we're just making a picture of your character. The poses are beautiful, and I really like the animations. The backgrounds fit with it too. What do you guys think of my Revenant? I think it's beautiful. So the mock battle lets you fight with your own customized character, so you can see your own customized character fight. Isn't that fun? Okay, now I'm gonna check the Soul Calibur. So guys, I can't wait to see your guys and girls customization. Please share it in my Discord. We're gonna have some fun with this. I really like the soundtracks in this game. It chooses like the perfect tunes in battle, or whenever you'll fight, or whenever the story is exciting. It sounds very magical and it really fits in the story and in this game. The gameplay is very enjoyable. You can do many things during the battle, like counter, guard impact, throw, stunning, blocking. The special beautiful moves called critical edge and the reversal edge is also interesting. It's like rock, paper, scissors system. So if you choose a move, the other has to choose a move that counters it, so it's all about luck. I really like 3D gameplay. I wasn't used to this, but when I'm playing this again, it feels more open and looks like you can do more things like dodging and spacing. I like it when you are on the ground and you move to the other side to stand up. That's only possible in 3D fighting games, and I kind of miss this. I used to say 3D fighting games is not my thing. But whenever I played this again, I was like, oh, it's kind of cool again. The ring out must be one of my favorite features in this game. Yeah, I told you guys already what I think about the ring out, but it's so freaking cool. So whenever you push your opponent out of the 3D stage, he falls down and loses a round. It's amazing if it happens to you. One of the best feelings in gaming. The stages look incredible. They look so gorgeous. The characters in the game look very polished compared to the network test beta. I'm glad to see the difference. The critical edge super moves are amazing. I really like the way they look like, and the animation is unreal. They look super cool. I love this game. I like the lore. Now I found out about the stories of the characters. I'm enjoying to play my favorites even more now. The storytelling was kinda not my preferred style in short, but the story was good enough. And there are also the story side missions for every character and library of souls. My favorite part of the whole game is the customization. I think most gamers will enjoy this so much. The gameplay is enjoyable. I'll definitely try to improve in this game just like how I did in Mortal Kombat and play with you guys. I really hope they add like a mode what makes us able to play with each other at once, like King of the Hill. So my final score for this game is 8 out of 10. So definitely a recommendation for you guys. There's a lot of content, enjoyable customization, and online play will be challenging. I hope to play with you sometime during a live stream. So let's help each other and get good as a community, guys. Let's do this! Trying to hold my feet.